harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there are they that carry us away captive, required of us of song. They that wasted us, required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. Verse 4, everybody read that. Sing the Lord's song in a strange land. I want you to jump over with me now to Acts chapter number 16. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. Praise his name. When you dare say word. Verse number 22 says, and the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrates ripped off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the jailers heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bands were loose. But I ask you to just put your Bibles down and reach over, grab a hold to the person that beside you. We're going to pray. Amen. You hold it to an overnight hand. You hold it to a miracle. Amen. That person has been through a lot. They shouldn't even be here tonight. They're not here by accident, they're here by providence. I want you to gently squeeze the hand that you hold. Atasha Tosa. This new convention, hallelujah. In this time, I want you to gently squeeze the hand. Keto Shata. Just squeeze the hand and just say, Jesus. Press Jesus in those hands. Press miracles in those hands. Press a breakthrough in those hands. Eternal God and Father, I will shout about him. We give you praise for tonight. We bless you for your love and your mercies. Loving Spirit have kept us to be alive, Lord, your God alone from before times began. If it had not been for you, God, we would not be in your house. It's all because of your grace, your mercies, and your love why we're here. As we gather together, we come from far and wide, gather together, Lord God, to hear the dropping of the word. If you were here in the physical form, this is where you would be standing. God, as I stand here, Lord, I pray that you will sanctify me. Shana Boku Shima Sikata Madahusha Hatusha. Let me know your mind. Communicate to me your will and counsel. And I will speak directly to the heart of the people that they will know that you heal and answer prayer. God, I pray that you will lift up a standard. Sanctify the bishop of the south, sanctify his wife, sanctify the clergy, every officer, every minister, every saint, sanctify the choir, sanctify the congregation, sanctify those who are listening on the earwaves. God, I pray that you will let them be a washing. Cleanse us, because anytime you're sanctified, you always pull out power. God, we pray that you will move tonight like you'll never move. I stand in my apostolic fullness, and I command this community to come under apostolic order. I plead the superior blood of the life of Calvary. I render every day powerless. I bind the strong man over this region right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, I pray that you dispatch a gallows of warring angels to fight against those that fight against us. I bind every witchcraft spirit, I shut down every word of words. I bind human spirit and self-glorifying spirit. Every spirit of sabotage, I stand in my position as an apostle. But I blast it out of the atmosphere right now. God, I pray that you will arise and let the enemies be scattered. Fill somebody tonight, heal somebody tonight. Move like you've never moved. I call Shatama. Let them be, let me say, I stand on the mountain of fire, and I release the glory of God. Lord, let me find a fire tonight. God Almighty, from the rush of the pew, move in this house. Magnify yourself. We'll be careful to honor and bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody say in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. I want to provoke you to be a little uncomfortable tonight in the gospel. Even though we're packed tonight, just make a switch and sit beside somebody and change your seat right quick. Amen. Please just make a switch. Some of your choir members over this side, go over that side. Mix the thing up. Yeah. The more we are together, the happier we shall be. Oh, yes. Amen. Just make a switch. Move from where you are and sit someplace else. Make yourself uncomfortable. Sit beside someone who came here for something. Hallelujah. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. Somebody said glory. Somebody said glory. All those who came here from Awesome Church tonight, jump on your feet and shout hallelujah. I'm still telling you, I don't know what is going on. I'm saying it again, but it's a setup. I've been praying, Bishop, and asking God, what is going on? Praise God. I wake up so early after I go to bed so late as usual. Amen. Almost 4 o'clock. I got up so early then after 8 minutes to 9 years old. I don't sleep yet. Amen. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what is going on. So I'm going to speak as it comes. I'm going to speak if I don't even sound profound. I'm just going to talk. Amen. I'm going to let God have his way. Since God wants me here, might as well I just open myself. And if you tell me to say, I'm going to say. Leave on your neighbor, just tell your neighbor. I've got something to tell you tonight. Tell him, I don't know about you, but nothing will stop my worship. Yeah, that's what I'm going to preach tonight. That's what I'm going to preach tonight. I want to look at somebody else and tell a neighbor, my good neighbor. Give them my fine, give them my fine. So shake them, say, neighbor, if you really didn't come to worship, don't sit beside me now, because I don't want no baggage. These are crazy. This last part of this week is crazy. Anything is not able to happen at this time. Praise God. So tell the person that's on the side, say, neighbor, my good neighbor, if you did not come to worship, do not sit beside me. Praise God. I came here to give God some praise. And I'm now trying to the person, give them my time. I tell them nothing will stop my worship. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah to God. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Get now better. Praise God. It's good to be here. Amen. Praise God. So, the night that I saw God concerning what to say, Mommy Baby, it's good to see you, Mommy. Amen. Pops, you're not big. Amen. Amen. God is good. As I saw God concerning what to say, wanted to know his mind. Praise the name of the Lord for the body of Christ at the time as this. It is a critical error. Praise the name of the Lord, where you've got to make sure, amen, that you're hearing from God. Amen. Praise God. It's good to listen to Jakes and Owen Jones and Apostle Smith and all them fine preachers on the other side, those who preach the word of God, praise God. But I know a fact that whenever you come in before a congregation, amen, of God's people, it is important for us to see the mind of God, to hear what God wants to say to his house. Praise God Almighty. Another thing that I learned during time growing up in ministry, that while you're preaching, you should listen. Because God has a way to change the order. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. So there's a lot of people that don't know, praise God, that you have to seek God. Amen. To get a word. I'm not too brilliant to go Google a message. Praise God. So I got to go the old fashioned way and ask God for his direction. Amen. I believe that there should be a move of God whenever you get in the house of God. So much of us cannot gather together from far and wide and got this jump back with the power of the Holy Ghost and come to one place and leave out without nothing happening. Something must happen. Oh God, you got your neighbor telling me, I don't know about you, but I didn't come to see if something would happen. I talked to them and said, I didn't come to wonder if something is going to happen, but I came here to make something happen. Are there anyone that came here to make something happen? Praise Amen. The song of the solitary, praise God, are known as spiritual songs. Praise God, right there. God instructed, amen, many authors, praise God, to write, and they put pen to paper, praise the name of the Lord, and they write the song to encourage Israel. Whenever they scattered all over, and at any time they went up to Jerusalem, praise God, they would quote songs, praise God, sing them, chant them, especially when they're going up to the feast and they gather together, they're singing these songs and enjoying themselves, entertaining God's presence while going up. Even when they're going to Pentecost, praise God, they were chanting their song and feeling good, preparing for an explosion, because Pentecost is an explosion. Amen. Gear up for worship. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, many of the Psalms, amen, praise God, were attributed to David. Amen. And some to Moses, some of the sons of Korah, different people wrote some Psalms. I try to find out the author of this one, praise God. While some are saying it's attributed to Jeremiah, or 17, it's attributed to David, praise God Almighty. I just talk so something that, praise God. We look at David. David is no stranger to us. Praise the name of the Lord. We know him as a shepherd boy. And I'm not doing all of that. Just saying something. Praise God. That David, when he was called out by God, praise the name of the Lord, he was anointed, praise God Almighty, in three dimensions. Praise God. One of the first stage of his anointing, praise God, that God allowed him to be anointed first before his brethren. His own brothers recognized that he was anointed. Amen. And anytime God is going to use you, he got to make sure that he anoints you in front of your own. But you got to understand that even though you're anointed in front of your own may not receive you. Because according to the scriptures, a prophet is without honor, saying in his own country. Amen. And among his own king. Amen. It's bad, but that's the truth. Amen. If you remember clearly, Joseph got up with his dream. And when he spoke of the dream, it was cool. Amen. But when they heard the end of the dream, that their sheaves bowed before his, that's when they got upset. Amen. And when he spoke of the other one about the 11 star and the sun and the moon, amen, it was sounding good until they heard that they bowed before him. Even his very daddy got upset. Amen. Because not everybody can handle your success. Hallelujah. You've got to know that the Lord is doing something in your life. Remember clearly that when Joseph was going to take food for his brethren, that the first thing they say, let's kill the dreamer, and so we can see what will become of his dream. So they really didn't have much problem with day Joseph say this book of many colors. Amen. And the dream that's on his head, if they can kill you, then the vision won't come to fruition. But as long as the dream is out, no heavenly head can kill you there. Oh, God, I feel good. So God sent David to Samuel down to Jesse's house to anoint a king. And you know that when he got in there, that his sons, Jesse's sons, paraded before Samuel. And as soon as Samuel saw his firstborn, amen, he said, surely the Lord's anointing is upon him. Now, if you remember that when he was to anoint Saul as king, he did not have to choose between nobody else. Saul was just looking for his daddy's assets. And while he was looking for them, God whispered in Samuel's ears that at a certain time, this young man will come and he will be the one. Now, when he got to Jesse's house, the game changed. Now, God didn't even tell him the name of who he should anoint. God only told him that there is a king out there that you need to go and anoint. When he got in there, his fleshly tendencies got the better of him. Because as soon as he saw Eliab, the first thing that came to his mind was how Saul looked when he anointed him. So he looked at the structure of Eliab and said, surely this is the Lord's anointing. But when
your noise or your education or your money or your dress that breaks you, oh God. It's the anointing that not only break it, but destroy it. Anointed. Amen. Excuse me, that's a joke. Not everybody's anointed. Praise the name of the Lord. God only anoints vessels to use for His glory. Hallelujah, God. If you're saved with the gift of the Holy Ghost, you are anointed. I'm hearing people who are not even saved say they're too blessed to be stressed, who are anointed to be disappointed. The devil is a liar. Is for the church. Oh, see that I'm preaching to myself. So let me go. I tell you, I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm doing what I'm feeling in my spirit. Amen. So now David prays the name of the Lord. Amen. He was about to anoint them, and you know that they tried and nothing could happen until David came in the room. As soon as David walked in, the anointed responded. So this is the man. This is the man. The anointed David. Much, didn't look like much, because he tells Bishop, a true anointed man of God, a true anointed man of God is able to see in an individual something that nobody else don't see, and can speak in your life, and they become what the man of God, who may not see. That's the problem. The problem that preacher Andre is that we wait until the person manifests, then he says, surely something is going to go. That's not how God do it. Trust you before anything starts to manifest, because he knows that later on you will never be disappointed. God Almighty. The Bible says, the first time David was then anointed, he was anointed before his brethren. He went back to the bush. The second time he was anointed before all Judah. Amen. And the third time that he was anointed before the entire nation of Israel. Now they knew he was a king. Now the third dimension of anointing that he had, first he was anointed as a king. And as a king, he had the rulership ability. Anything he said is going to pass. The second stage of the anointing that he had, praise the name of the Lord, he was anointed as a priest. Amen. It was a priestly anointing that was on a triple four anointing. As a priest, when, if you remember correct, hallelujah, God, when he came to Ziklag and saw that Ziklag was messed up, amen, and everybody spake of stoning him, instead of asking Abiathar to go in and ask God, because Abiathar is the priest. Abiathar should go and inquire of God what's going on, but instead, David said, give me the ephod. And he put the ephod on and went in by himself. Oh, hallelujah, God. So from the second stage of the anointing, the third dimension of anointing that he had, he was now anointed, a prophetic anointing. He was a prophetic anointing in him. This is why he went like this. My Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou here until I make your enemies your footstool. He was not talking about himself. He was speaking in messianic terms. Hallelujah. And he said, Lord, he was not speaking of himself. He was speaking of the Messiah, Jesus Christ, the great God of glory that was coming. So that the Lord also grant us the triple fold anointing. We are kings and priests in the earth. This is why, as an anointed individual, you cannot live ordinary and act like your regular. Can I preach on my feet? Amen. The anointing does two things for you. Yeah, yeah. The anointing will make people love you. Suit and good house and give your car and give a nice dress. They will embrace you and talk to you nicely, and then time you show up, they will run along beside you and talk to you. And that's one. But there's another one that the anointing does. The anointing make people eat your cross. My God Almighty. Because what happened, preacher, is that the anointing in you, when the anointing, and the anointing in individual, when the presence of smallness, it's not having an attitude, because you're going to present it in your
happen. The wrong is all right. But when the wrong will never come. I need to know how you saw. I need to know if you're anointed. Sit on preachers, put in the young preacher under pressure. Talk to all the persons in the neighbor. I am anointed. The devil don't like me because I'm anointed. They can't stand you because you're anointed.
I'm not putting a defense
makes it wrong, I'm a new and defensive. Nothing can penetrate you. Nothing can stop you. If they set your face at flip, set yours at flip. Let them try all they make. They can't stop what I'm about to do in your life.
I'm not a whole she's it.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Jeremiah was telling them that if you don't change, you will find yourself in captivity. They thought he was a joker. They thought he was a joke because everything was going good for them. Amen. Praise God. And went it so so that pressure boxing and pushing and pit and in stocks. And I'm telling that God will make your terror to your own self. They will do everything. And when the Nebuchadnezzar came to take over Jerusalem and turn back, amen, didn't get to capture Jerusalem at the time. But Jeremiah had to run because they said the thief is a lie told. But not many time days after, then the Nebuchadnezzar came and he stripped, hallelujah, Jerusalem. Amen. He took the best out of Jerusalem. Amen. He took, amen, Daniel, Azariah, Mishael, Azariah, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He took all those who was of royal descent, and he took the chosen vessels from the Lord, and he stripped the temple of Solomon, and he mashed on the walls of Jerusalem, and take all the best of the best, and keep them into his domain, because he wants the best to make sure that his structure is going on good. So the Bible says that here they were now, finding where they are, and remembering where they were. They remember Jerusalem. So the Bible says, we wept when we remember Zion. So you preachers remember clearly that Zion was captivated, a covered rather, protected, and the Jebusite lives in the Zion. And they say is that even the fever can guard Zion, because Zion, amen, was with 45 mountains around it, and everything was going good. Zion was good. And they say, even and the lane, nobody can penetrate it. But they didn't know that God made a warrior, a man by the name of David, who said by him I'd run to a troop, and by my God I'd leap over a wall. Bless be the Lord God, my strength, for by him I'd broken a bow of steel by my arm. They didn't know David was so a warrior that he couldn't have salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? They didn't understand how bad David was. Amen. When David was a boy, he took on a champion. That was a champion from a youth. The light of God. Amen. Stood six cubits and a span. He's everybody in Israel. place. Zion is an exalted place. Shut up. and saying, these are men who are the most high God that come to show us the way of the Lord. She taught the truth. It's something good, but she continued to say it. And that's what they did. It don't know when to stop. I will preach to real people. If the devil puts under pressure yesterday, it should lead you today. Because you get a chance now to lead you back. That's how you come to church, go sit and show the Lord that you want beside you. You get a chance to. Can I preach this? It's a spirit that Richard talked about. It's a spirit that has been now prevalent in Jamaica and in the world. Because everybody wants a work. They want somebody to prophesy on them. You live like the devil. I want somebody to tell you going to hell. You go to heaven, rather. If they were telling you to go to hell, you would understand. They want somebody to tell them. You just got him with your pocket for him. And you want somebody to tell you that you're going to heaven. So then get under them teachers having interviews who are not hearing from God, but telling people that what they want. You want to be rich. Now the latest thing that is happening is everybody can call somebody's name. And these prophets, P-R-O-F-I-T, prophets. These prophets, the only thing they can do is prophesy your bank account number. I know some of them watching me now, and I know they've been trying something for a long time. But it's not killing me. When I was just inside, then I'm out now. And this is not where I'm at. They're not dead like Johnny Baptist. Nobody knock up off my head. Now come a fire like Elijah. I'm going on some trial. Always to suit themselves, Lord Jesus Christ. And now, because they don't have it, they feel they know they're not getting no invitation to go no place to preach. Now they made a FaceTime. Thank God for Facebook. Give them FaceTime so they can stay in their home, watch you and kitchen, and say them preaching. And wanting somebody to like it and say something that the devil is lying. But a false spirit running out of a long and time. Outside the church, you don't know the woman, the man, and try the spirit. Bishop Lord always say, try the spirit. It's not anyone that say that Jews are Jews. That will put a blood man in mind. But you got the Holy Ghost saying at all. And you take one over to try the spirit, then you go back to the altar. And that means something wrong with your spirit. You got money. And you got the spirit of God in at all. You don't even know that I can reach. That something is offline. And even now, anytime you start talking about spirit, some people get this. Because they know there are devils in there. And you have to let the devil accompany them. It is like too much devils sitting in the apostolic church. We need to burn fire. Let the Holy Ghost come up. Let the devil stay in the house. So the spirit of divination is like privilege. They tell you something and it sounds right. Pentoshama. It's a form of witchcraft. It is phobia. Necromancy. Interpretations are juju. And some people in the church still go hold them on. Somebody don't say anything because it's too much. Which one? see a woman run. Then I then was turning around the side and then stepping back. but they fasten their feet with stocks, so their back is sore, and their feet fast with stocks, and they were in a dark dungeon.
They answer, look. They didn't say hallelujah, I'm going to
you cannot connect with somebody who is wounded and still trusting God. It is the person to another person that has everything going on but out of their heart. So you can't have a non-worshipper hanging with a worshipper. So you have to be careful now. Who is it you are connected to? Ask them, where is your heart? Ask them. Ask them where your timbre. Ask them where your hallelujah. Tell them that's your heart. Ask them. Tell them, answer them. Tell them, I need for you to give me an answer.
Yeah.
Mama Shanda. Midnight prayer dangerous.
Yeah.